My brother, he was killed for nothing. He was an innocent man. So I'm not gonna let his death be in vain. I didn't want him to be another guy on a t-shirt. I think they heard me loud and clear. I talked for a while trying to let them know that my brother, his death would not be in vain. I told him how much I loved him, how much he was a role model to people that's growing up around me. We all loved him and the world loved him too, because we all protesting because we're tired of what's going on right now. I'm gonna speak out as much as I can because he has the platform now, and he also elevated me to be able to speak for him in his death. I haven't had a chance to grieve like I wanted to because I've been trying to get his message across. But I'm on my way. Hopefully I have a chance to just sit back and think about what's going on, because everything has been coming so fast right now.
I believe that we have a real opportunity of getting people to come from across the aisle and change the culture and the behavior of policing in America. We went to Congress because we know if there's going to be a change in policing in America, it has to start at the top. And so the lawmakers, even on the other side of the aisle, were literally saying that we have to do something about this qualified immunity, these choke holds, these body camera videos. That's what the George Floyd law is going to speak to.